So, can I just tell you guys that I am totally in love with the internet? I know. A lot of people have told me when I get into a relationship like this, Colton, you need to take it slow. Don't start throwing the L word around. But it's serious. I'm addicted. Bad. Let me give you some statistics from my networking sites, shall we? Okay. On my YouTube, I have subscribed to 315 people. Let's see. People subscribe to me. I reached 60 today. As far as Tumblr goes, I am following 534 people, and I have 189 followers. Excuse me. And for the final one, I am following 197 Twitters, and I am being followed by 112. I love the internet. Because I have friends. I mean, the internet. The internet understands me. I can talk to the internet. I can express my emotions to the internet. I can talk to with the internet day and night for hours upon end and never get bored. I love the internet. No, but really, a lot of people nowadays in our society are too focused on the internet our phones, the computers, e-readers, freaking iPods and MP3 players, that we forgot what it's like to write a letter, or a poem, or a story, what it's like to make our own music, what it's like to dance to the beat of our own drum, what it's like to smell the pages of your favorite book and feel safe and escape this world. We've forgotten how to communicate. I mean, think about it. Most of the world, most of America are not, America is not the majority of, YouTubers are not a majority in America. Because to be a YouTuber, you have to be able to communicate. You have to be able to express yourself. You have to be able to say things clearly, or as clearly as you possibly can. And a lot of people don't know how to do that anymore. I mean, I hear people bragging, oh, I got the insert e-reader here thing for Christmas, and I love it. It's so much better than a book. What are you talking about? No, it's not. Because yes, with an e-reader, you can have hundreds and hundreds of books in a small, compact place. You don't have to worry about packing these things to go on a trip, but you are missing out on so much of the magic that goes on inside of a book, within a physical book. Because within a book, when you open it for the first time, that is an amazing feeling. When you the smell of the pages, the way the ink looks on this page, the way the page feels in your fingers, what it looks like when you have a damaged book that's got some dents and dings and it has character, these are the things that a book has that an e-reader doesn't, and nothing will ever replace. I take that back. Technology is replacing books, but nothing will replace the nostalgia associated with an actual physical book. An actual physical book is reading one of those. There's so much more cathartic to read than an e-reader, a book on an e-reader. And I don't care who you are. Yes, I have an e-reader. I'll admit to it. But I still buy books. I still buy physical hard copies. As far as music goes, people forget that there is something other than auto-tune out there. They forget that they can create their music if they want. I have two drums, one here, one up there. People forget that they can do that. People forget that they can whistle, that they can hum, that they can belt a tune and express themselves. People forget that they can communicate face to face. People forget that they can communicate through a handwritten letter. I mean, these are things that in two or three generations' time, it's going to be a rarity. Honestly, I feel sorry for my kids. My kids are going to be the kids in school that know what a VCR is, and they're gonna know what a DVD player was, and what a frickin' Motorola Razr was, or what, you know, like, they're gonna know that stuff. I can't even express how upset it makes me that technology is taking over something like this. Because something like this, it shouldn't be. No, it's irritating. You know, pick up an actual book. Write a story. Write a letter to someone. Read a book, write a letter, make your own music, and talk to someone face to face for more than a minute. Please, please. Because you will understand that person so much more if you will sit and have a conversation with them over coffee, over tea, over a book. Read about a book. Talk about a book together. Like, seriously. Before I go on too much more of a rant, I am going to go. Because I'm going to clean and get my house ready for a party I'm having in 2 days. A get-together. Not really a party. I don't like the term party. I prefer the term get-together. Anyway, I love you guys so much. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys keep subscribing and watching me. And I love you. Mwah. Bye, guys.